All right, hello again, YouTube. This is going to be an audio-only video, kind of like a podcast, like I used to do. So I just I just wanted to talk briefly about this. You know, I saw a video online. Somebody had posted about, you know, the Pirate Bay going down and or being taken offline or whatever the hell the gist of the language or narrative you want to use. And it seems, you know, again and again, reading from the comments that, you know, people do not understand how the internet works. And I've watched this story unfold for years now about the Pirate Bay. And funny thing, of course, like I don't really use the Pirate Bay. I've never really bothered with it because, like, what the fuck am I going to do on Pirate Bay? What I always found funny, though, is their letters. They have like a letters area or whatever. And you can read the sort of the veiled threats that they've received over the years, and their kind of not so subtle you know, responses, which I found to be a little bit funny. But otherwise, you know, the thing that kind of bothers me about this, I mean, it's not like the pirate. First of all, the Pirate Bay is not down. Okay, it's down somewhere. Okay, but the thing about this, I guess, the way that they've put this together. And sort of following this over the years, it is very redundant. I mean, you guys have to understand, you know, the key point here is that it is on the World Wide Web. It is not on the fucking Swedish web where, you know, this server that they were running was taken down. And I don't think it's the server, from what I'm reading, it's the sort of traffic load balancing server, which, and what that does is when you have incoming traffic, it'll basically pick a server to share out the latest what do you call them, threads. You know, probably should have done a little bit of research on this because you know, I mean, I have been reading this on and off. It's just funny though, everyone sort of like getting all, you know, ass hurt about like, oh, Pirate Bay, you know, they're so bad, they make, you know, piracy, all this happen, yada yada yada. It's just, listen, I mean, you know what the problem is? You know, it's not even a problem so much as these fucking sites are going to be up forever. There's nothing that can be done about them. You have to understand redundancy. This is the World Wide Web. It'll pop up in some fucking pocket of the world somewhere and come back online. You know, in previous instances, I've seen, for instance, the commercial domains, the .coms, you know, being sort of confiscated by the U.S. government. Of course, the U.S. government controls the .com namespace. So what in that instance, yeah, they can go ahead and seize domains. So in other words, if you have somethingsomething.com, they can say, well, you're using this for piracy, or for I've seen them, I think it started with counterfeit websites or sites that were in illegal gambling, I think was something about that. And they went ahead and seized those websites. So sure, I mean, you can seize the .com space, but yeah, there's a lot of fucking namespaces, guys. They're all over the world. And this is the point I'm trying to make about this, is that, I mean, I work on the web. My job is on the web. I've done this for 15 years and plus, actually, you know, but it just, you know, we've had the internet for, oh geez, 30 years now. And you'd think that these fucking idiots who run, you know, the government would figure this shit out, or they would hire somebody who knows what the fuck they're talking about. Because, listen, guys, this whole Pirate Bay thing is never gonna end. This is a cat and mouse game with a hydra. You know, the mouse is a hydra. It's, you're gonna cut the one head off, it'll pop up somewhere else, and it's just like, for fuck's sake, can we fucking agree that, like, the system that we have is broken and that we have to fix it, and that, you know, you're going to try to hunt these people down to enforce broken business models, like for copyrighted material like music and movies. And, you know, it's kind of like this, I'm always sort of in the back of my mind referring to this quote from the Star Wars movie where Princess Leia talks to Darth Vader, you know, about, you know, the more you tighten the grasp, tighten your fingers, the more, you know, oh shit, I'm totally butchering this quote now. But you know, in other words, the more you tighten your grip, the less control you have, and pretty much that's the way it is. We got to find a way to work together as a society, and I think, you know, yeah, there's going to be people who are going to download things like software, movies, and music and whatnot. And that's the way the culture has gone for, oh God, like, you know, at least 15 years now. And, you know, things like Napster and you know, way back in the day they had, I think it was, what was it, LimeWire and all these other, like, file sharing websites that became very, very popular. Or was it, I think it's Torrent, sorry, I don't partake, so I'm not very hip with the lingo. But again, it's sort of like, no matter what, I mean, let's say today it's torrenting, tomorrow it'll be something else. They'll find a new way to share information. And that's, I guess, the point I'm trying to make. Information will always seek in the human condition to be free and open, and we'll find a way, you know, kind of a thing. Even if it's fucking carrier pigeons, what are they gonna outlaw fucking carrier pigeons at some point? Come the fuck on. It gets really, what am I trying to say here? It gets obnoxious listening to this shit over and over again, droning on, and then you got the government coming in and saying, oh, we gotta make harsher penalties and draft new legislation for handling all of this copyright infringement and all. It's just fucking like, can you guys just, you know, maybe, I don't know, offer a fucking decent product and not, you know, kneecap, you know, the access to said, you know, stuff. I mean, stuff like Netflix is a perfect example of creating a marketplace where you pay a fee and you are, you can easily access stuff that, I mean, I don't know if Netflix even works up here in Canada, but, you know, stuff like that is just sort of a really good solution. And I think there's Hulu in the States. There's all these little sites that have crept up, and even something that's very mainstream like iTunes, you know, showing that, yes, there is a marketplace. And if you guys would just fucking learn about how to engage, you know, your audience, and I'm talking specifically to business people who are, you know, in these ivory towers that they've built up over the years and created these walled garden marketplaces where they control everything, and sort of like, yeah, it must have been nice for a while. But again, you are dealing with fundamentally flawed business models that cannot and will not survive. You know, you're talking about people who have gotten so used to monopolies and sort of having their way, but yet, you know, they fail to understand or even acknowledge that the marketplace is changing, the conditions under which business is done is changing. And I mean, I'm seeing this with everything from, you know, the DRM on video games to, you know, content control systems in, you know, like, for instance, HDMI, if you guys are familiar with HDMI, of course you should be at this point with HD, is encoded. There's a handshake operation. It's a DRM scheme where, you know, the television has to say, you know, oh yeah, I perfectly understand that, you know, we're not allowed to show encrypted or whatever the fuck it is, some protocol that they have to use, you know, to satisfy Hollywood's demands. But it's sort of what I think is even more pervasive and ignorant is the fact that these people in Hollywood fail to realize that they're not the only game in town. You know, it's not like every piece of media and music and all this other culturally significant media comes from Hollywood. You know, it comes from all over the world. And that's what is annoying about this, is that it seems like we're catering to a single group of individual people and companies who seem hell-bent on getting their way. And I think that's no way to run the internet. The internet is worldwide, and we have to take that into account, that there are many people's needs here and not just a group of, you know, individuals or large companies or even, you know, certain governments. The world has to get on the same page, and I think, again, this will not change anything. You know, if Pirate Bay was down permanently, which it probably isn't, judging by the comments that I'm reading, that this is going to continue on and on and on until these fucking idiots, you know, get it through their fucking heads that, no, you cannot have a monopoly on media and copyright on every goddamn thing under the sun. Okay, you can't take culture. There's derivative works. There's all kinds of other considerations, prior art. You know, these things make it impossible to own culture, okay? You might have an original idea or IP, but, you know, again, in the end, we all got to share and learn how to fucking get along. So that's it for me. I'm running out of time on this one. I hope you guys have enjoyed my little rant here, and hopefully I'll do a little more of these in the future. So for now, thank you so much for watching.